Find the sweet spot and become a force on court. This is the Head Graphene 360 Plus Gravity Mid Plus. With a 16 by 20 string pattern and flexible construction, this 100 square inch racket blends control and feel with a rounder frame geometry for easier access to spin. Graphene 360 Plus technology is integrated into the frame, combining stability and power along with spiral fibers in the lower head for a cleaner feel at impact. This racket features a 3 points headlight balance, a 62 stiffness rating, and a swing weight of 323. First up, we have Brittany. Now, you and I were on the Radical Mid Plus review. How did this new Gravity Mid Plus work out for you?
Now, I've play tested a lot of head rackets over the years, and the Radical Mid Plus was one of them. And for me, the feeling of those rackets wasn't my preferred feel. And I think Gravity has taken a step in the right direction for me. I really liked the responsive feel I got from this frame. I thought I could hit my targets very well. I could take a little bit riskier shots at times. It is a little bit lower powered, more on the controlled side, more controlled than the Radical too. So I tend to look for a little bit more power, but I really enjoyed that controlled response that I got. When I came to serves though, I really liked that I could pick my targets. I could hit a variety of serves, whether I was slicing it out wide, taking a little bit off and hitting a kick serve. I really could kind of dial it in and use that variety to my advantage. If I had one small negative, it would be I felt it was unstable at times. It is a 295 gram racket, so it wasn't surprising to me. You know, it didn't feel any less unstable than other rackets in that area or in that weight. Overall, I really liked the fun flip cosmetics of this racket. I thought it was really unique, and I think players that have used head rackets in the past or maybe haven't should definitely take this one out for a demo.
Next up, we have Jason. Now, you've hit with a number of different head rackets in the past. How did this Gravity MP stack up?
Yeah, you know, I actually used to be a head player. I used to use the TI, FlexPoint, MicroJoe Radicals, even the original Speed Pro. But then I kind of went away from the brand, but I feel like with the Gravity, I can feel it pulling me back. This racket just does a lot of things very well. It's easy to use, maneuverable. It's fairly comfortable. I was able to get a lot of spin on my shots, easy depth on it as well. So, you know, I was able to just play my game really well with this racket. I will say my favorite thing about it is the feel, like Brittany mentioned. In previous few generations of head rackets, I thought those rackets were a little bit too muted, feel a little disconnected from my shots, but with this one, I feel like the racket's pretty responsive, and I know where my shots are going, so I really enjoyed that about it. My one slight negative would be that it's a little light for me. I would like to see it in like the 11.3, 11.4 ounce range, because it tends to get pushed around against bigger hitters. But other than that, I really enjoy the cosmetic. I really enjoy how I played with the racket. I really enjoyed the feel, and it's the best head racket I've tested in many years.
Next up, we have Julie. Now, your current racket of choice, the Beast 98, is a 16-20 string pattern. This is also a 16x20 string pattern. What did you think of this frame?
Yeah, I mean, safe to say that I love 16x20 string patterns. It's really like easy to generate power and spin with these string patterns. Now, it is a 10.4 unstrung weight, which is a little light for me. So the racket did get pushed around a little bit. So on the baseline, I had one rule, like really keep your racket speed going. Whether I was attacking or defending, I was swinging fast to make sure I was reaching the depth I wanted. Especially on my backhand, because I have the tendency of just like hitting hard through the ball. Though doing this with the with this racket, I my balls were just falling a little short. So yeah, once I found the right launch angle on my backhand, I just had the depth I wanted, and I was a smooth right from there. Didn't have any type of issues with my forehand either. You know, like I have a full Western forehand grip, and with my launch angle being pretty high, I didn't have any trouble reaching my depth. At net, it was very quick and responsive. I was actually really surprised with the control I had at net. I really could put the ball wherever I wanted, and I could also hit like nice droppers just where I wanted. So that was really nice. On my serves, first serves, I was usually just aiming big and T. So I totally find my targets there, and on my second serves, it was very easy to generate spin, so I could find some consistency in my second serves with a kick serve, you know. And yeah, overall, very good racket, and I think that's my favorite of the headline.
I was also on this playtest of the Head Gravity Mid Plus, and I really enjoyed this frame. The 1620 string pattern, I used to play with the old Babolat Pure Control, which had a 1620 string pattern as well. And I also played with the Head Extremes back in the day when they had a rounder head shape, and this racket definitely brought me back. I felt like it was kind of the best of both worlds in a sense. On the ground strokes, I found it to be super predictable. Definitely, I could get good control and pretty nice spin out of it, especially because of that rounder head shape. Also on the slices, I could knife the slices really low. And transitioning into net, I found excellent control, excellent touch and feel up in net, hit great drop volleys with this frame. The one downside up in net, I would prefer a little bit of weight. Just for my personal preference, it's an 11-ounce strongweight racket, so it's not unstable from the weight perspective, but just for my personal preference, I would try to get it up a little bit higher. On serves, I found I had really good precision with this racket. I did also manage to get really good action on the ball because of the round head shape yet again. And on returns, I really actually enjoyed to chip and come in with this racket because I found it was quite stable, especially on chip returns if I was taking the ball really early. It's very comfortable as well. And overall, if you're a modern player who's looking for a really comfortable, really feel control oriented racket, you should definitely give this racket a demo. We strung this Head Gravity Mid Plus up with Head Hawk Touch 17 gauge at 52 pounds. For more information on this racket or anything else tennis related, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, and Tennis Only.